When you think about the process of bringing together a management team, as you're doing now, how would you engage them in such a way that you're picking the team and motivating the team so that you can get the best out of them? How do you go about the process of getting the best players and keeping them inspired?
Well, it's a lot of fun. I've done it before, and I'm doing it again right now. I think, first of all, you've got to have a common set of goals and objectives that everybody kind of agrees on. And so the frequency of meetings could be fairly high, as you're doing that. And in our case, I mean, our team is meeting weekly, and we're reviewing the business, how's the business going, what are our customers telling us, what are we delivering that they love, what are we not delivering, what are competitors doing, what do we need to change, you know, what are our kind of core metrics look like. But first of all, you want everybody to realize that we're all basically, you know, handcuffed together, and we all go up or down together. And, you know, you don't have one guy succeeding, another guy failing. We're going to talk about how do we help each other succeed, and what does each other need to cause ultimate success for the company. So really getting a shared set of goals that we're all locked on together.
When I talk to so many entrepreneurs and CEOs about this process of engagement with really creative, really passionate people, they come from diverse backgrounds, you want all of that, but it's natural for conflicts and contention to erupt. And some of that's a good thing and some of that's a bad thing. How do you harvest the conflict that comes from having really highly engaged people? I mean, some of these meetings, a CEO doesn't invite outsiders to because they're so contentious. Could you talk about that?
You know, we love debate. Debate's fantastic, but we love data too. So facts. So, you know, we're sort of a bunch of fact-driven folks, and so we like to, you know, if we're having a discussion and it's getting fairly emotional, and we don't have a lot of data, that's really not very useful. So you call a timeout and say, okay, let's go get the following, you know, five pieces of information, and let's come back and look at the data, and then we'll decide what to do. But, you know, the facts are our friend, and we'll go with facts, nine times out of ten.
When you think about the many large organizations, having the kind of level of debate is sometimes difficult. It seems that some people have come to the table a bit intimidated with being able to vet the tough issues. How do you draw people out so that they can give you the hard facts when you need them?
You know, it's almost a precondition for being on the team. You know, if you're not able to do that, I'm not sure it's the right team for you to be on. So, first of all, I think you got to have capable folks. You don't want to have a group that's too large, because then you just don't get the kind of participation that you want from everyone. You don't have engaging and deep discussions. And you kind of go back to what are the principles of what we're trying to accomplish here. And everybody's sort of aligned together. We succeed or fail together. And, you know, we do it, you know, based around data. And also we do it with a view towards what's going to be best for our shareholders, what's going to be best for our customers. And actually the right answer, you know, almost always is